Hi friends, welcome back, and it's a new day with some new crafting. And today I'm going to do this SMDF letter decor piece, and I thought why not to shoot a video of this one. This is something which I'm making on order, and I'm so excited that it's for one of my favorite TV actor, and I'm not sure if I can name him now because it's a surprise for him, but maybe I can. And his name is Zaheer Sheikh, and I just love him. And when I got this order, I was extremely excited. I was literally jumping because I am a big follower of him, and I was asked to make a monogram for his room, and I thought I'll shoot a video of this one as a tutorial, and let's get started. Okay, so here I have been given a task to add this name to this S letter, and I'm going to do all the mixed media stuff. So to start with, first I am going to arrange these words so that you know what we are going to name him for this monogram. Okay, so let's get started. And it's actually super fun. You all know that I love making mixed media projects, and altering MDF is my favorite thing to do, and I love using these stuff and creating something new. And if you can guess it, what it is, yeah, it's Super Shah. I really don't know why this name, but I'm more excited that I'm making something for him. Yeah, so I'm super happy, and I'm super excited, and I'm creating super S. Yes, so here my alphabet is arranged. Maybe I can shift this a little down so that maybe I can shift it to a little center. And this looks good to me. Okay, so I'm going to keep this, arrange this as it is, and now I'm going to first stick this. And okay, so now I'll start sticking with these, and then I'm going to work on it. So I'm using my liquid adhesive to stick this, and I just need to make sure that I stick them properly, because otherwise it is actually going to change the alignment, and it won't look good, and I don't want this. And yeah, so as you know that once I'm done with the sticking work, I'm going to prep up my base, and for that I'm going to use my gesso. So in MDF, basically you get two options. One is you get the raw base, the cutout or the box or the tray, whatever you have, or there is an option where you get the polished one, where you really don't need to apply any primer to it. Like prepping up the base is not required for that. And I personally feel that I am more comfortable with the raw base, because I work with different textures, I'm going to use different things, and at times the look and finish of the raw base is totally different than what you see on the prepped up base, the already sealed one. So I think that's the basic difference, and that's the only reason why I usually buy my all the MDF stuff raw, without any polishing or without any coat to it. One thing, while sticking these alphabets, you need to be really careful, because see, if I'm holding my project like this, I'm going to write stick all my alphabets in a tilted form, which we don't want, because once you keep the S like this, it has to be straight. So like you can see, my R is a little tilted. I'll adjust my H this, and now I'm going to stick this one. So these are the small things you need to take care, and make sure you don't do any blunders with this. And now with my heat gun. I'm going to dry this, and yeah, so I'm done with arranging this. I just need to move my S a little. Okay, and now I'm going to dry this, and then we'll be back with all our mixed media supplies. Okay, so here my alphabets have almost dried, and I have decided to use my white and blue shades on this, and I am going to use my gesso first to prepping up the base, but I thought why not to add some more texture to it. So like you know, I am really so excited with the new granule paste from Crafty Scrappers, and I thought I'll use this one. So you can see the texture it has, and I'll be using this with my small palette knife, and I'll be just spreading it all around. And once I'm done with this, then I am going to do my gesso work. So there are two options. One is you just prep up your base, add colors to it, and that's how you work. The other option is you do all your texture work, and then you prep up the base and add shades to it. So if you see, there is a very thin line and a difference. Like if you are prepping up your base, then you can directly use your texture pastes. So if you are prepping up your base, and once you're done with the gesso, you can directly start using your shades. And if you have not done anything, do all the texture work, whatever you want to do, and then you start with your this coloring work. So it's super easy and super fast. So here I'm just going to highlight the remaining portion. I really don't want to mess up with this area because my text is going to hide out. So I'm just adding texture, this granule paste, on these sides, and I'm going to cover as much as I can, and the bottom line is it should look good. Okay, so here I am done. Maybe I'll just do some highlighting work here and there. And I'm just covering the sides. I'm not going to do anything on my alphabets now. And now I need to cover up this area also. So if you actually want to see what is inside this, so you can you see this white granule? So it's a very very thin and very tiny balls inside. So it's really really fine balls, and it gives a really nice texture. Oops. And I am almost done. Yeah, and here I'm almost done. Now again, I'm going to use my heat gun, and I'm going to dry this up completely. Okay. Just cover this area also. Yeah. Now I'm done with my granule paste work, and now I am going to use my heat gun to speed up the drying process, and then again I'll be back. Okay, so here my MDF piece has dried out. I thought so my texture has almost dried out. It's not completely, but it has almost dried out. So I thought why not to add my gesso so that I can dry both the things together, and then I'll be doing my coloring work. So now for applying gesso, I'm having my paintbrush, and with this I'm just going to cover up the remaining areas. and I'm going to cover it completely. I'm a big fan of Finnabear gesso and I completely love it. And now I'm going to stick this on all the sides. Just make sure that you cover all these edges so that when you add your colors it blends well, it works well, and you can play around with so many supplies. So I'm not sure if you noticed, even if I'm using my brush on these granule paste, the granules are not coming out at all. So that's the best part. So I think that's one of the very much required thing when you are doing a mixed media project, because we artists are so uncertain. We really don't know, and we do lots of experiments, lots and lots of, at least I do lots of experiment, and I love it when I have already done my one layer and that second layer does not mix well and I get the thing what I really want. So it's always good. Okay, now I'm going to cover this up. So in gesso you get three options, that is white gesso, black gesso and clear gesso. I recently got black gesso also. I haven't tried clear gesso till now, but honestly I think white and black are sufficient. I think the clear gesso is really good for your journal projects, maybe. I don't know, I still need to figure it out that where to use your clear gesso so that I can order one very soon, and hopefully I will order that also. So here I have covered most of my areas. I just felt I need to add some more gesso on my S, and I will make sure that I don't leave these lump of gessos. Gesso, and because these are actually going to hide my alphabet. These are actually going to hide the proper shape of these alphabets. It's almost done. I have done some more videos on MDF alphabets. I did one V, I did one A, and I think it was J or R I did, and I'm just realizing that almost all of them are in blue white combination only. Maybe, yeah, all of them are in white and blue combination only, and I just realized that I have been doing all my monograms in white and blue combination. So maybe with my second project I need to change my color palettes for monogram so that you guys can see the variety. But even if I go ahead with the same color combination, you will realize that all these monograms are totally different. Like in one, I actually picked up the theme from one of my tea light holder, which I did with a wooden plank. If you check my video list, it's in the altered project list. So it was actually a wooden plank and I converted it into a hanging tea light holder, and which is really 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 dear to me. I love that project, and trust me, it's still with me. I haven't given it to anyone. I got some inquiries for that, but I said no, it's not for sale. So it's still with me. I haven't hanged it anywhere, but still it's with me, and I don't feel like giving it to anyone or selling it off. So likewise, I have a big box full of my supplies, and yes, I do take custom orders, but I still don't feel like selling that particular piece. Okay, now I am going to cover the sides, because side is really really important, and this is something which is going to be visible and it is going to have so many shades once I do my acrylic color on this. And now I need to let it dry. Now, because it's a little winter, a little cold here in Bangalore, so my project takes a little time. Like, I was working on a canvas, a big canvas. It was a 2 feet by 1 feet canvas yesterday. Actually, it took me 2 days, the complete 2 days to finish that. Otherwise, usually I finish my project in the canvas project in 1 day's time with all the drying process and everything. So yeah, it is a little time taking process for me now, but it's fun. So I'll be sharing those pictures on my blog, and my blog link is www.growingcraft.com, and there you can see all my projects, almost all my projects. And there are many projects which I do off camera, and I'm not able to have a tutorial for that because maybe I run out of time, or I work so late night that it's not possible for me to shoot a video, or it has too many things which is really difficult for me to capture on camera. So there are quite few projects which I do off camera. Like, I recently also did diaries. It was for a corporate order, and I did some embossing one on it, and it was really nice. It was really exciting because I loved making those diaries also. And by now I'm done with my gesso on the outer side. I need to cover up this area also. So I'm going to plan a video with the difference in gesso and the difference, the difference of using gesso, how it really makes your project different and how it looks. And this is actually going to help you guys. I've done a recent video on chalk paints. To check that, I really love that video because it is really going to help you out if you are a newbie and you want to buy those supplies but is really confused that why to buy chalk paints or why to buy acrylic paints and what's the basic difference in both these things. So yeah, in that way it really helps. So yeah, here I'm done. I'm not going to cover the backside of this monogram right now. I'll do it only once I'm done with the complete coloring work, because now it is going to get really messy with all the colors which I'm going to use. So now I'm going to let it dry, use my colors, and then at the end I will be doing the backside part once my complete monogram work is done. Here my S is done, and now I'm going to use my color. So for this I've decided to use my shimmer paste, that is Martina color, Martina shade, and I am going to use my acrylic color. This is one of my recent favorite. I got this very recently. I did that big canvas with this and now this project, and I thought why not to use this one. And like I said, I wanted to do this project in white and blue color, so these are like perfect blue shades for me. So first I'm going to use my acrylic color, and then I'm going to start with this shade of blue in shimmer paste. So here I have my brush. I'm just going to take some color. Maybe I think I need to get my, okay, maybe I can have it here. Okay, and now I'm going to use some water and I'm just going to spread it like this, and I'm going to add some more water to it so that it spreads. And likewise, I'm going to cover these shades. And I just need to make sure that I don't use a big patch of color, because I really don't want to have that highlighted blue, which I'm going to cover it up on my alphabets. So I want my background to have more of whites and less of blue. And can you see, this looks absolutely fab. Maybe I just need to okay, and I'm going to repeat the same process on all the sides. So here is a trick: if you think that you have added too much of color, immediately add a drop of water and you're good to go. And and please make sure that you tilt your project really well, because this actually helps in smudging the colors to your background, and this gives a really, really nice effect. And with this you can see how fab it looks. I'm absolutely fine even if my color is going on my alphabets, because later on I am going to have some texture on it, this one. So I'm okay with that color also. I need to add some more water. Usually for these projects I use my shimmer sprays, and but it's just that I loved this shade and I did not had my shimmer spray of this shade, so I thought maybe I will use my acrylic color for this. But now after using shimmer sprays for such a long time, I actually feel that they save lots of time. You just spray it, add some water splash, and your project is good to go. But with acrylic you need to color everywhere. You need to make sure that you don't leave out any area. But then I think that's okay. That's the fun part of working on different projects. And if you really notice, okay, can you see the nice texture here? So that's the best part of granule paste, because you can play around with the colors and you can see all those patchy things, and it looks fab. It actually looks great in real. And I wish I really knew the best camera settings to show you how amazing this project is looking now, even while working. Now I'm just going to spread some water, and I just need to spread this one only, because I don't want two dark blue shades, because I want to highlight this super sharp. And for this I just need to add some colors to it. And here it is almost done. Even if you feel it's looking a little patchy, that's okay, because it is looking really nice in person. So it's okay, it's absolutely fine. None of your projects has to be just perfect with everything. And I think that's the reason we call it mixed media projects. So here I am almost done. Maybe I think I should add some more, a little blue here. And I'm done. And yeah, and now I am finally done. So it's ready now. Again, need to dry it up, and I'm going to use my heat gun for that. So I'm done with the drying process, and now it's time to highlight my alphabets here. So for this I'm going to use my shimmer paste. Now usually I love using my palette knife for shimmer paste, but for this particular one I thought I will be using my paint brush. I think this is good to coat. This really has nice flat bristle, and it will be easy for me to apply this. And I'm going to have my texture paste, this shimmered texture paste on these. And I'm just going to apply a coat of this on my alphabet. And can you see that it's actually highlighting, it's actually making it a little popping out from the S, and S is popping out from S. Wow, what a PJ. Okay, so I'm going to repeat the same for all the alphabets, and here I'm not really concerned that it should look very thick or something, because I want it to be really thin. I don't want too many textures here, so I'll just apply a thin coat of shimmer paste. Oops, maybe I took too much of shimmer paste here. And as you can see, there is a little difference. So these two blue has a little different. So I am going to use my acrylic paints again. But before that, I had to cover my wooden letters so that I know that where I will have to work. And. So if you are wondering that, oh my, this jar is empty, or how much product it has, it has a really good quantity of product, and I have been using this for almost a year, but maybe 7-8 months, and I have used this like anything on my projects. And I even made sure that I use a good quantity, because I really love these shimmer pastes, shimmer sprays. So when I use them, I use them like anything, and I really love the final outcome, and I really love how the dried shimmer pastes and sprays look. Now you can definitely get so many brands out there, you can check them also, and it's fun. It really makes your work easy, it gives a nice dimension to your project, and that's the best part of it. So here I am almost done. I've been asked that what do I do to keep myself motivated for crafting. I listen to lots and lots and lots of music. I think I really can't do crafting without music, so I always have my Bluetooth speaker on whenever I'm inside the craft room, because I really love that. And anyways, I love music. I'm a typical Bollywood person, a typical Bollywood person I am, and I love hearing all those old songs, 90s songs. So I have a big playlist which just keeps on repeating one after another, and that's the fun part. Okay, so here I am done with my texture shimmer paste, and now again I'm going to dry it up, and then we'll start highlighting the outside of this alphabet with some gray shade. No. So now here on a palette, I'm going to take my gray color. It's chalk paint, and I'm going to highlight my alphabets with this. I'm going to add a drop of black color to it to give it a little darker shade. This is optional. If you are happy with the color you have on your monogram, let me slow down the volume of the music. Okay, yeah. So if you are happy with the color you have, you really don't need to mix black acrylic paint, but here I'm using my acrylic paint on with my chalk paint, and I'm going to use this to highlight my alphabet. Okay, so now I'm just going to run this on the edges, and I'm going to repeat the same process of adding some water to it. This is just going to highlight my alphabet. So it is another trip, just a tip, just take a dot of color, dip your brush in the water, and then immediately start using it. So you can see the shade of gray. Maybe I'll zoom in the camera. Okay, now if you can make out the difference, that this is a little highlighter than these ones, because it has a gray layer to it on the side. So just take some color, dip in the water, and then immediately use it, and then you can see the gray shade. You can change the consistency if you want. You can have a little darker shade, a lighter shade, depends on what kind of shadow effect you want to have in your project. So I'm just going to make sure that I highlight these corners a little more, like this one and this one, because these are actually going to differentiate between all my alphabets out there. And I'm going to repeat it here, just a drop of water, and you need to repeat this on all the corners. To fill in a little bit inside this, and I'm going to add some more chalk paint. This is my first time experience. I've never ever mixed my chalk paint with acrylic paint, but I think just adding a drop of color makes a huge difference. It's not that you should always mix your colors, because chalk paint has its own charm, has its own complete different finish, which is really good, and it's a complete mash matte thing. So, but if your project requires, you can surely do experiments. Now I'm going to add some more here. I'm thinking that I will highlight my alphabets, these alphabets, a little more, and for that I will need my acrylic color, the blue acrylic color which I used on my project here and there. And if you are a newbie, please make sure that you always have a wet wipe or tissue paper with you while making your mixed media projects, because it actually helps. Like when I started, I used to have a big pack of tissue papers and wet wipes with me, because it actually helps in like just removing the extra color. But once you get used to it, I think it's super easy, and you have that control on picking up the colors, the paints and everything, so it makes your work really easy. And I'm just going to add some touch of grease here. So here what I'm doing is I'm just highlighting this S portion along with my alphabets. And now I'll again zoom out. Okay, I missed out that on camera. So here what I did is I just had my gray shade here. This is just to highlight this portion and my words, not these two corners, because this is something which is having the name. And now on this I am going to use my acrylic color, and I'll keep this aside. I'll dip my brush and I'm just going to dip it on my alphabet. So if you can see, this is actually changing the color of my texture paste. So I'm not going to do this on the complete S, just some portion, and this is just to highlight my alphabet. So if you can see, I have this sea blue and aqua blue, and this is actually highlighting my alphabets. While watching a video, it looks super easy, it looks super fun. Yes, it is super fun, but it is actually very tricky and very complicated thing, because you need to be really perfect, you need to have a good control with your supplies, otherwise it can go blunder. So it's fun plus too much of work, and but it's fun, but it is fun. So I'm not sure if you know this, that my daughter, she has a YouTube channel, and of lately I have been promoting her channel a lot, and I really want to promote her channel, because she has been working really hard. She is just 6 and she really needs to concentrate on her studies and playing and everything, but she makes sure that she makes kids videos and tutorials. And now she's in design team of Nagashri Arts, which is really encouraging and really a big thing for a kid of her age. So if she is putting up so much effort, then I can really help her in growing her channel. Okay, so I'm sharing her channel link down in the description box, do check that. And with this, I'm almost done with my project on the top side. Now I just need to add color to it. So here what I'm going to do is I'm going to take darker blue, the same shade, like without any water, and I'm going to cover it up here on the sides, and this is actually going to give a nice border to it. done with coloring my edges, and I just thought that the final thing I should actually highlight these edges a little more. So again, I'm going to add some water to my color, and you can see my table is already so mess, so I am going to use this only, and I'm just going to highlight my S here and with a very very thin color layer here. And this is completely optional. This is something I felt that I should highlight, and it might look good, and I think it is actually looking quite good here. It is giving a nice border to it. I'll add some more color, some more water. Okay. And I'm going to do the same on the edges. And I'm just spreading it a little bit so that it looks a little more natural. And just highlighting the edges. So now I feel that after highlighting the borders, this looks a little more good, and I'm liking the border color. So in short, I'm really in love with this shade, and I really don't know how many more projects I'm going to do with this shade. And I think this is actually going to look really good with black color also. Maybe I should try this shade with black color too, maybe. So after this, I'm going to make some more tutorials with my shades, and I'm going to make sure that I use different shades for you all. And now my alphabet is ready. I'll just give it a little touch up. Maybe I need to add a little bit of color here and there, and I'm done. So now once it dries out completely, I'm going to use my wood varnish. It's an Asian Paint or PU wood varnish. It's a water-based varnish, and with that my project is done. But before doing that, I'm going to make sure that my each layer which I've done in this project till now should dry completely so that it does not smudge. And I'm going to apply my wood varnish, and then I'm going to keep it for at least 24 hours to dry out, and then I'm going to send it. I really hope that Shahir likes this project, and fingers crossed. And thank you so much for watching. I'm listing all the supplies down below in the description box. Please do check that. And I'm really sorry if I'm not able to answer your or reply back to your messages on WhatsApp or Messenger. Please comment below in the description, in the comment section down below. It's easy for me to get all the queries and questions here, and I really love answering them. But it's just that connecting over the phone is a little task. So YouTube is a best way to connect with me or my Facebook page. And thank you so much for watching. Enjoy a few more pics of this artwork. And do stay tuned to my channel for some more updates. Bye-bye.